Welcome to the Cathedral of St. Matthew the Apostle, especially to those who are visiting with us today. Today we celebrate the Mass of the Lord's Supper. We encourage you to join in the spoken and sung responses and hymns for the Mass. Today's music leaflet is available from the ministers of hospitality at the entrances. We ask that you return them after Mass. Leading us in our celebration today is Cardinal Wilton Gregory, Archbishop of Washington. Please note that the verses of the opening hymn will be sung alternating between Spanish and English, beginning with verse 1 in Spanish. Please rise.
Till all the world. In el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo.
Amen.
La paz esté con todos ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Dearest friends in the Lord, on this night as we call to mind Jesus' example of perfect love, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the sacrificial Lamb of God. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Lord Jesus, you give us a new commandment to love one another. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in the most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les he transmitido, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan en sus manos y pronunciando la acción de gracias, lo partió y dijo: esto es mi cuerpo que se entrega por ustedes. Hagan esto en memoria mía. Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo: este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre que beban de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beben de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet? Jesus answered and said to him, what I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later. Peter said to him, you will never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me. Simon Peter said to him, Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well. Jesus said to him, whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all. For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, not all of you are clean. So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
TV food programs have become an increasingly popular media entertainment choice during the recent past, beginning perhaps with Julia Child's only a generation ago. There are now all types of food programs that describe countless nutritious, tantalizing, and easy to make meals. There are currently food channels that can help the novice chef navigate his or her way around the kitchen. There are even some food channels that are designed to help youngsters learn how to make healthy meals safely at home. Cooking channels have obviously tapped into an issue that many of us find both informative and entertaining at the same time. A few televised chefs have even become media stars in their own right, and several have acquired many fans who want to know how to prepare some of their famous cuisines. Some have even developed sounds that they make. Bam! The Exodus narrative of the first Passover that we just heard proclaimed contains an ageless recipe for freedom and faith. Our beloved Jewish neighbors, who in a month from now will themselves be celebrating their yearly feast of Passover, left a detailed account of the Seder meal that prefigured the perfect Passover that Christ has now entrusted to us. Both Jews and Christians during the springtime observe a cuisine that has much more to do with faith than with flavors. The first use of the blood of the slaughtered lamb that was originally shared during the Jewish Passover ceremony, we Christians believe, pointed to the blood of God's Lamb, who not only spares those living in the designated households whose doorposts are marked by that ritual blood, but the blood of this innocent lamb brings eternal life to all those living in the household of faith, who dine at the table of the Lamb and share his flesh and blood offered for the life of the world. La comida que se describe en el libro del Éxodo es de hecho una comida sencilla, pero preparada de acuerdo con el propio diseño de Dios. La propia receta de Dios para la salvación de su pueblo. Este Dios liberador invita a San Pueblo elegido a comer una comida de libertad para confirmar que las pertenece y que Él es su Dios. Es una comida que confirma ma relación con el Dios de la libertad y su pueblo que pronto será liberado de la esclavitud en Egipto. Jesus, faithful to his Jewish legacy, transforms that Paschal meal and renders it not simply a memento of events from the past, but through it, he allows his disciples and all of us as well to anticipate the future freedom that will ultimately include all of God's creation. A meal that recalled a passage from slavery into freedom. It becomes the sign of future glory for all those who dine with Christ in the Eucharistic sacrifice. The food elements that are shared in the Passover meal each hold the symbol of a reality far more important than the mere tastes of those food items. The bread and the wine of the Eucharist are so much more important than their appearance or their taste. Furthermore, the gospel passage from St. John that we just listened to on this Thursday evening tells us what we all must do because we dine on this sacrificial meal. We are to care for one another, to serve one another, to tend to one another's needs, most especially the needs of those who are poor and underprivileged. The Eucharist is the meal that spiritually strengthens each of us for service in our world. Ordinarily, good food provides us with the muscle and the energy to engage in all kinds of activities. Regular good nourishment helps us to perform well, to be physically energetic, and to respond eagerly to the world around us. St. John reminds us that the Eucharist is also intended to oblige us to follow Jesus in his mission of service, humble and self-effacing service to others, even to the point of washing each other's feet. Many people today like to watch food channels to learn how to cook. We Catholics everywhere listen this evening to the convivial story of the beginning of the Eucharist, to remember how we are intended to live. And most importantly, we listen in order to learn how to use the energy that the Eucharist provides to live as Christ did in generous serving service to others. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. The food that we share this evening and at every Mass is to strengthen us to accomplish the work to which Christ himself calls us. Eat heartily, my dearest friends. We have so much service to provide for a very needy world. And let it begin at this table. Amen.
And now to my dear elect and candidates for full communion. Over the past months, at this time of the liturgy, we have sent you out to reflect more deeply upon the scriptures. And now, as the Paschal Vigil draws near, the sacred night in which you will receive the sacraments of initiation into the body of Christ, we invite you to remain with us in prayer and holy expectation. And if everyone will now please stand.
Remembering the Lord's selfless love for us, we pray for the needs of all our sisters and brothers.
Kyrie.
Por la Iglesia, para que entre más profundamente en la contemplación de la pasión, muerte y resurrección de Cristo.
Christe, exaudi nos.
Leaders, may they promote peace and justice in their care for creation and all peoples.
Christe, exaudi nos.
Kyrie eleison.
Por los enfermos y moribundos, para que Dios les otorgue misericordia y sanación.
Christe, exaudi nos.
Kyrie.
For the elect, may they be filled with the hope of the life-giving Spirit in these final hours of baptismal preparation.
Christe, exaudi nos.
Kyrie.
Kyrie eleison.
Por nosotros aquí reunidos, para que perseverando en la oración y el ayuno, nos preparemos para renovar nuestro bautismo.
Christe, exaudi nos.
Kyrie.
Kyrie eleison.
Padre, escucha las oraciones que te ofrecemos y ayúdanos a reconocer a tu Hijo en la fracción del pan y en el servicio alegre al prójimo, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Thank you. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Concedenos, Señor, participar dignamente en estos misterioso, porque cada vez que se celebrar el memorial de este sacrificio, se realiza la obra de nuestra redención por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, with Roy and Juan and Avilio, our auxiliary bishops, with Donald William, our retired archbishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously, accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar manner, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, to command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants and those who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in the fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but I will say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Blood of Christ. The blood of Christ. Are we needed? Are we needed? Blood of Christ. The blood of Christ, amen. What's that? Right here.
Oremos, concédenos Dios Todopoderoso, que así como somos alimentados en esta vida con la cena pascual de tu Hijo, así también merezcamos ser saciados en el banquete eterno por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
After the liturgy concludes, the cathedral will stay open until 10 p.m. for those who wish to stay in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. And we ask that you please maintain silence after the liturgy.
Thank you. school.